Okay, so this is one of the many albums that I have not checked out this year. I've missed a bunch of stuff that is just incredible music. And I'm trying to get through as many as I possibly can in these last 2 weeks of December, just so I can make my end of the year stuff, like best songs, best albums, and stuff. I just felt like I didn't get through enough music in order to, have enough variety to choose from. But I ran a poll over on my community tab, and this one won by a long shot. I'm going to be doing Signs of the Swarms, Amongst the Low and Empty next. But yeah, man, this is a band that I thought I never heard of before, but I have these two songs liked from earlier this year. I don't remember them. I don't remember them at all. It's kind of weird that they're both on the 22nd. But I kind of skimmed through the tracks and I loved what I was hearing. I really did. So yeah, I'm excited to hear what their newer stuff sounds like, because those songs are older, I believe. So the most recent song I've heard from them is Eden on their most recent album. Well, the most recent one compared to the new one, their previous album. Don't know why that was so hard for me to say. And then I heard one, oh, all the way from 2011. Okay. So those are the only two tracks that I'm kind of aware of. I've probably only heard them a couple times. But yeah, I've heard a lot about this album. I've heard that it is very emotional and very progressive and is kind of up there with Heavener by Invent Animate in a lot of people's minds. And Heavener is hands down my number one album of the year. I don't think that anything could beat it. But if people are saying that this is on the same like level as that, especially in the emotional area, I'm very excited to hear it. And this is a long album too, with only 9 songs. 11-minute song is the biggest song on the album, so I'm expecting some very progressive shit here. Real quick before I get into this, it'd be awesome if you would subscribe. Sorry I didn't upload for like a week, but I'm back now. And yeah, man, let's get into this. I have no idea what to expect, so. That's weird. Oh shit. Oh my god, that scream is very unique. Crazy time signatures going on. Interesting mix. Was that atmosphere I wanted? Really interesting. crowd. I have no idea what's going to happen. At any point. Guitar sounds so unique. Maybe I'm just used to really low-tuned guitars. Yeah, there's some gorgeous stuff throughout this instrumental. Might lead into the next song. I don't know what to think yet. That was very unique. But damn, that was a really good opener. I feel like I need to hear more of them before I can say anything, though. Sorry, I had hair in my nose. When the daylight is dead and gone, the echo of a voice will come. It's a dangerous world, suffocates and burns. I would lie with you here, my friend. I would stay with you till the end. Don't be afraid to love that guitar. Control, this is so much different than what I was expecting. little Gojira on me right there. That is gorgeous, isn't it? Oh, vocals are crazy. Wow, just for that section, I'm liking this. This almost feels like it's going into like a separate section. Like that song ended, but now it's going into some outro. What's gonna happen? Thal. Oh. Two voices lost inside the ricochet. Oh, this, that gave me chills. This song is good. Oh, that did something to me. That might make it onto the end of the year best song list, like top 40 or whatever. That was an incredible song. Celestial. Oh, this was a fucking amazing intro. Oh. Activated right now. Best song now? I don't even know. This is an album I'm gonna have to listen to like 20 times before I can even. I don't even know. I don't have any words for that. That was the best song. I thought the last one was mind-blowing. This isn't, I've never heard anything like this. It has kind of like a classic metal influence as well. I don't even know how to speak on it. Some 808. What is the next song called, even? Legion. Each song's gotten better and better. Bellamy feature on here. Oh, that's sick. Oh, I love all the reverb on the drums. This is so dreamy. All this is building to something, or not. Whoa. What the fuck? Holy shit. This song is really interesting. It's beautiful. Vocals are insane. so unique. The vocal diversity is maybe the most I've ever heard. Oh, that is gorgeous. That might be one of the most like I'm high as shit right now, but that is insane what I'm hearing right now. That's eargasm right there. I don't know if I'll be able to review this. Like, fuck. You said like, this might beat Silent Planet, man, for number two. I don't know. I have no fucking idea anymore, man. Fuck. Did you ever think a mama could be in this world? You need to tell me. It's true. I'm thinking that was my least favorite. I don't know what even to say. Here we fucking go, man. Industrials, fuck. But the life in you ran cold. My tears turned to dread with words of life and Gojira. Oh shit. Definitely concept album. I've seen some reoccurring lyrics. This is incredible. We'll be right back. Flashbanged myself. God damn. I didn't even know how to react to that. I was just completely listening to the music in my own head and like spacing out. So I'm sorry. But yeah, that's one I'm going to have to listen to a couple more times for sure. Oh, this is different already.
For the sirens to echo, try to close my eyes and stay asleep. Now I can't afford to be so reluctant, and we can't afford this life.
Instrumental is very different, but I love it. What about all the seas? Different compared to the rest of the album anyway.
Stop!
Yeah, that was a beautiful song. And crazy time signatures. I mean, just so impressive, man. Oh, funky. I'm sorry if this is boring to watch, but I don't have any fucking words. Fuck, dude. Jesus. All right, last song. Already. Let's see how they end this, man. Beautiful like 30 times in this video. It's true, man. I don't know what else to say. Background atmosphere. Able to be left alone. You're in and out of circulation, treading lines, getting stuck at every sign. So turn your fucking nowhere. I love this sound, man. I first started loving that with like Infant Annihilator because they would do that every once in a while, but just like groovy bass out of nowhere, man. Oh, synth. I love how bright all the sound songs are. There's no real low. God damn, I'm sorry about that.
outro. Well, you know what I mean? There's no way the rest is just ambience, right? I mean, I'm fine with that, but... I listen to Nine Inch Nails, so I'm used to listening to 11 minutes of, noise. Their ambient sections and outros is, it's some of the most beautiful shit I've heard. It's just incredible. This album was just incredible. Gotta re-listen to that one. Fuck. I really don't know what to say. I genuinely, like, usually I talk too much, but fuck. I'm, like, speechless with this one. This is some of the most impressive instrumentation that I've heard maybe ever, and some of the most diverse and impressive vocals. So much diversity throughout the vocals. Every song is extremely unique, sounds completely different from the others. And those outros, man, those fucking gorgeous atmospheric outros with the guitar, the synth, or whatever they're using. Like, I wish they would almost make an album like Loathe did. They came out with a album called The Things They Believe, and it was all ambience. I Let It In had some of the most beautiful atmosphere I've ever heard as well. And they came out with that, and it's gorgeous. But I really wish that Tesseract would do that. I feel like they would make a really fucking awesome thing with that. I'm just rambling at this point. Fucking holy shit, was that progressive though. I think I'm gonna rate this thing a 96 out of 100, which ties it with the Silent Planet album for now. I think I'm gonna change the ratings later. But this is a tough one. This is a really tough one. Because I connected with the Silent Planet one more, but I think that's because I know their whole discography, and I've known them for a very long time. And I loved the ambience on that album a lot. And, of course, the heavy shit and everything else, but there's just something special about that album's... Anyway, so we'll just see in 2 weeks when I come out with the best albums. I'll see if where this lands. I'll have to listen to it a couple more times, of course, so I don't know what to say right now, but for now, I think it's just going to be tied with the Silent Planet album until I figure it out. But anyway, thanks for watching. Definitely let me know what album I should check out by them next, because I was looking through their albums a little bit, and based on the album art and just the titles of the albums and the songs, I think that they kind of dive into, like, space kind of celestial stuff, and I kind of got that vibe a little bit from this album on one of the songs. But it looks like this album is a complete departure from what they've done in the past, and yeah, the art's a lot different, and the concept I don't see anything else like that on their discography. On their Spotify, it was kind of giving me like Northlane kind of vibes with the geometrical stuff, and they have a lot of space theme stuff, concepts throughout their first couple albums. So yeah, I'm really interested in this band. Like, I'm really fucking interested to see what other concepts that they have in their stuff, especially Portals, because the art is really cool with, like, that monolith. And Sonder, that art's really awesome with the solar system. There's, like, alien technology and shit. This is so cool. Definitely let me know if I should start at the beginning or maybe work my way back.
But I probably won't, again, I'll probably won't get into any of that until next year, January, just because I'm focusing on the 2023 stuff. But yeah, if you're interested in that, definitely subscribe. To subscribe as well if you're interested in those album polls that I do over on the community tab. And yeah, that's basically it. Suggest what you want down in the comments, like the video, and yeah, take it easy.